Hello, this is Tutorials by Olivia, and today we will be making Mega Charizard X. In the tutorial, I make him a little bit differently. So the wings are going to be white instead of dark blue, and the body's black. Sorry, dark blue instead of black. And the horns and the arm spikes are white instead of light blue. I do tell you all the differences while I am placing the bands in the tutorial, so you do not need to worry. So let's get into the tutorial. So we're gonna start out with some of the repetitive parts, like the spikes on the wing. My inner part of my wing is going to be white. If you're making normal Mega Charizard, you're going to use dark blue. So let's get started. You want to take two dark blue bands and put it at the top center peg. And then we're switching to single bands. So take a single band, put it under that one, and then another single band under that one. One more single band off to the side. Another single band off to the side. And mirror it on the other side. And then we're going to close it off, so from the side to the center, and from the side to the center again. We're going to put on our holding bands, which is one double looped blue band, and put it right here. Another double looped blue band, so twist around your hook once, and make a triangle. Okay, so now we're done placing all of our bands for the wing spikes. We have to still put on a capping band. So the capping band, wrap it around your hook or your peg four times. You can see it has four little rings. And put it on the end. The whole wingtip will be dark blue. So wherever you see me putting white, put dark blue. Okay, reach under that white capping band and grab the first rubber band. Not the first two rubber bands, just the first single rubber band. Go in for the next one and for the last one. Again, reach in here, loop up, reach in. Oh, these are two rubber bands, so you're going to want to make sure to grab both of them. And then here, reach in, make sure you don't loop the cap, the holding band, loop up. Reach in, grab the bottom one, loop up. Reach in, grab the bottom one, loop up. Again, on this side. Okay, so now we're done looping. I know it's kind of hard to see because my background's white and so is the tips of my wing. But we're now gonna slip knot it off. Make sure that the slip knot is a different color, because we're going to take it off, so you need to distinguish the slip knot from the wing. So I'm using hot pink. So reach in, just a normal slip knot. So you don't want to make it as tight as you would normally a slip knot, so that you can take it off easily. And do this for all three of the ends. So there's the middle one. And here is the side one. Okay. Now you can pull it off the loom. And kind of straighten it out. Pull out the capping band. Even out these slip knotted parts. Have it like here. Don't worry if it's too narrow. It's going to widen out when we put it on our wing. And so you're going to want to make five more of these. So you have a total of six. Okay, so now we're going to make the arm spikes. So you're going to want to take one black band, double loop it, put it on your loom anywhere. A light blue band, double loop it, put it under that one, and then a capping band that's light blue. Wrap it around your hook or your peg 4 times. Put it right here. Reach under, grab the bottom double loop band and loop up. And then you're gonna want to pull this out of the loom and make 3 more of these. Now we're going to make the horn. So take 1 double looped black band, put it on your loom, 1 more double looped black band, and 1 more double looped black band. So you have 3 double looped black bands. And then you're going to want to take a light blue band, double loop it, put it right here under all of your black bands. For your capping band, you're going to want to have a light blue band that's wrapped around your hook or your peg 4 times, so you have 4 rings. Put it on, reach under that one, grab the first double looped band, then looping up, making sure you're only grabbing the bottom double loop band. Pull it off your loom, and there you have your horn. You're going to want to make 1 more of these, so you have 2. Okay, so now we're going to make the smaller spikes for the wing. So you're going to want to take 2 dark blue bands, put it anywhere on your loom, another 2 dark blue bands, take 1 dark blue band, double loop it, put it under all your other dark blue bands, capping band, 1 dark blue band, wrapped around your hook or your peg 4 times. Put it on, reach under, loop up, reach under, loop up, pretty basic looming. Pull it off, and you're going to want to make 3 more of these. So you have a total of 4 of them, 2 for each wing. So now we're gonna make the spikes on the back of Charizard. I'm not just sure, but he might have spikes all the way down on his body, or just on his neck. If you know, just make 2. If you don't, make 5. So now I'm going to show you how to make them. Take 3 black bands and put them anywhere on your loom. And then take 1 black band, wrap around your hook 4 times, and put it on the end. Reach under, grab all 3 of those bands. And then if you're just gonna make the ones for the neck, make 1 more of these. If you're gonna make the ones for the body, make 4 more of those. So now we're going to make the feet. Take 3 black bands. I'm using blue, so just whenever I use dark blue, you use black. So take 3 black bands, you're going to want to put it on the center, right there. Another 3 black bands, right here. And another 3 black bands. So you have 3 sets of 3 black bands. And take 1 black band, double loop it. Put it on your loom like so. Another 1, double loop it. Put it on your loom. Another 1, double loop it, put it on your loom. Make sure you got both parts of the double loop band. And now we're going to be switching to silver. I'm going to be using black, because that's the color I'm going to make my claws. So take 1 silver, double loop it, put it on here. Another silver, double loop it, put it on. So basically on each of these ends we're going to be putting 2 double loops over. So 2 on this one. And yeah, 2 on this one. Now we're going to capping off all of our ends with it wrapped around our hook or our peg 4 times, it doesn't matter. and put that capping band on each of those ends. So there's one, there's two, and here's three. So reach under that capping band, grab that double looped silver band, again, loop up, just stop right there, reach under the capping band, loop up, reach under, loop up, stop where the silver ends, reach under, up. Just be very careful with these double loop bands as they can snap really easily. Okay, so now we're going to do the black. Loop up, to the center. Reach under all these double loop bands and grab the three black bands underneath. Again, grab the three black bands to there. Now we're going to very carefully rip it off. I'm going to do pull off the claws first, like so. And then I'm going to pull off the rest. That way it's easier. By the way, I would highly, highly recommend using a metal hook for this project. If you use a plastic one, there's a chance it will break. So, go back so you have 2 feet instead of just one. And now we are going to make the arms. Just a note, you will need the arm spikes for these, so if you didn't make those, go back to the beginning of my video and make them. Take one double looped black, put it on the center. Another double looped black, put it on the center. Go down two more with double looped black. So one and two. Take a double looped black band off to the side. Double looped black band in the center. Double looped black band off to the side. Push all those ends down. Now take a double looped silver, put it right here. We're gonna do one instead of two on the arms. So right there and right here. Again, we're gonna cap off all of our ends. Loop around your hook or your peg 4 times so you have 4 rings. Put it here. Put it here. And put it here. Okay, now we're going to put on our arm spikes. So take your holding hook, put one here, and the other one pointing the opposite direction. So it kind of looks like that. Just a side note, be very careful when looping this band as it's going to be lots of tension on that peg. Okay, so reach under the capping band, loop up, reach under, loop up, reach under the capping band, and loop up. Okay, loop up to the center, reach under, grab the double loop band. Again, there's a lot of tension, so do it slowly. Continue, and like I said, there is going to be a whole lot of tension on this peg, so loop this last band carefully. Like I said, do it carefully, mine just broke. Okay, so now you have that band looped. I'm going to take off the toes first, and then the foot part, and then this part. And now I'm going to take it off carefully. You don't want it to snap now. And now you have your arm. Bend these white part up so it's pointing upwards, like so. And then go back and make another arm so you have those. And we are now making the wing, like so. Wherever you see me put down a white, you're gonna wanna put down dark blue. And wherever you see me put down dark blue, put down black. Okay, so for this, you should have three wing spikes, two smaller wing spikes, and I'm going to show you how to make the claw right now. So wrap one black band around your hook four times, then double loop another one on the other side and pull that capping band onto it. So you have it like here, and then take three bands and pull that double looped band onto it. So here's our wing claw. Set that aside. And now we can make our wing. Just a warning really quick. You're gonna need the whole loom of these two pin bars. So you have a broken pin on one of these sides. Make sure that you pick the side that does not have the broken pin. Okay, so without further ado, let's get started. Everything in this wing is going to be two bands. So take two white bands here, and we're gonna go down 10 times. So that's two, that's three, that is four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. And now we're switching to black, and we're going to go down to here. There, just follow my actions. Almost there. Okay, and there we are. And now we're going to go diagonally to the white part. And then down to the bottom of the loop. So now you see why you cannot have this peg broken. Alright, so cap it off with one black band wrapped around your hook or your peg four times. Put it here, like so. I'm just gonna squish down all of my bands because we're gonna be putting more on. And then go five pegs from this peg. So one, two, three, four, five, right here. And that is where we're going to touch the wing claw. Don't mix it up with the spikes. It's the one with the double loops band on it. Put it right here on the fifth peg. And now for attaching the small wing spike, put both ends on your hook and onto this peg. And now for attaching the bigger wing spikes, take one side of it, and put it here. Do not quite take off the slip knot bands yet. Here. Okay, so it looks like this. And we're gonna do that same thing for the rest of them. Except we're gonna kind of overlap it right here. Actually, sorry, don't do that. We want to take off our slip knots first. Okay, so just pull it off. Pull the small part. If you need to, you can cut these off. I'm gonna pause the video. Okay, so now for the next O-wing spike, grab one of the sides, and here's where I said overlap it, just put it on that one, and this one here, and this one here. So it looks like this. And now for the next one, doing the same thing. Here. Here. And here. Okay, so now you got all the big ones on. Now for the last smaller one. Put it on right here. So this is what your wing should look out like with all of the spikes. And we're just going to take off the slip knots. I'm going to pause the video because it's pretty repetitive. And you should be able to do it on your own. Okay, so now you have all of your spikes on and all of your slip knots off. We are going to add the holding bands. I'm going to use dark blue. You are going to use dark blue as well. Putting mine right here. They're all double looped. Take a double looped dark blue. Double looped dark blue. Double looped dark blue. Careful on this one, don't want it to pop off. Double looped dark blue. And just do the same thing all the way up. Stop right here on this one. Here. 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 And you're done. Now all we have to do is start looping. So reach in through the capping band and grab the two black bands underneath. Chin, grab two black bands. Grab the two black bands on top and grab the two dark blue bands on top. Grab the two dark blue bands on the bottom. Grab the two dark blue bands on the bottom. Make sure the ones that are on the bottom, because you don't want to loop your spikes. Okay, so now you have both of those looped there. And we're going to reach under again and grab the bottom two dark blue bands. And again, reach under, grab the bottom two dark blue. Reach under, grab the bottom two dark blue. Make sure you don't grab the spikes. Then it will fall apart. If you need to, you can kind of use your fingers to separate it from the rest. Okay, so now you have that one. Loop up. Reach under and pop. Okay, so now we're done with the hardest part of the wing. Just basic looming from here on. Make sure you don't loop the capping band. Here it's going to be a little harder. Grab the bottom two. Okay, might have gone a little fast there, but you could just pause the video. Now we're going to slip knot off the ends of our wing like before. So just slip knot off both ends. Make sure it's looser so you can take it off later. And now for the big reveal, we get to pull it off. Okay, I have absolutely no idea what that broken band is. Just pull it out if that happened to you. Okay. So now you want to stretch it out. You don't want it to be so curved unless you think it's awesome. I kind of do. Looks kind of cool. You're going to want to go back and make another one. Yes, I know. Not fun. Okay, so now we're going to start with the head. All of the bands are double looped, and wherever you see me put down blue, you are going to put down black. If you're making normal, like a Charizard. Okay, so you're going to want to start on the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The seventh space, not the peg from the bottom. So right here, this space between these two pegs, put a double looped black band. Like so. And then you're going to want to take another double looped black band, and then we're just going to go all the way down to the end. Okay, and so now we're gonna go from this side, right here, and go all the way down to the end. Wait, to this peg. Second to bottom peg. And then we're going to do on the same thing on the other side. So double looped black band right here. Double looped black right here. Double looped black right here. And so on until we get to here. Alright, and now we're just going to push down all of these bands, because we're going to add in holding bands, and take another double looped black from this side to the center, another double looped black from the side to the center. Capping band, wrap it around your hook or your peg. Four times, so you have four rings. Now you're going to add on our horns. So on the fifth peg, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right here. It doesn't look right. Okay, I put it one peg down because I miscounted. And then put your other horn on the other side. You kind of want them tilting backwards. So like that. And now for the holding bands. We're gonna do the eyes. The holding bands are double looped. I'm doing black for the eyes. You are going to do red, or one red band and one white band. And now for the second one, just put it right in top of the first one. And then do this, switching to double looped black. And there's two double looped on each spot for holding the band. Okay, and then we're going to kind of pull it upwards so it forms a triangle, like so. And now we're going to make our jaw. Your jaw is going to be the same color as my jaw if you are doing normal Mega Charizard. Normal Mega Charizard has a light blue jaw. So take your hook and wrap a band around like 5 or 6 times, more than usual. And then take 2 bands. And slide that capping band on and put both ends on your hook. Take another 2 bands and slide the other two bands onto it. Now you have your jaw like this. And we're going to take a double looped black, stretch it out, and put your jaw onto it. Like so. And put it on your loom. Like this. And now for the holding bands on behind the horns, we're just going to do 1 double looped. So, like this. You can kind of see how my holding bands are. And just like to warn you that during looping, it's going to be very hard to not break a band. If you do break a band, go to the end of my mini Charizard tutorial and I'll show you how to fix a band if they break. But if you did the head on my mini Charizard, you should be able to do it on this one because it's pretty much the same thing with just different colors and a little bit longer. So, carefully reach under the capping band. Grab the double looped band. Oh, I got part of one band and part of the other. Okay, so reach in, loop up, reach in, loop up. Make sure the horns are adjusted nicely. And then go in here, reach in, loop up, reach in, loop up, reach it, loop up. Okay, carefully, because it's going to be tighter with the horns. Loop. Alright, if you need to, swirl around your hook on the peg to release some tension. Okay, now we're gonna slip off all of our ends like we did with the wings. So grab your slip knot color that is different from the other dude's body and pull slip knot all of them, just basic slip knot. Nothing special about it. If you're doing a project this hard, you should know how to do basic slip knots and looping and holding bands. Okay, now we are going to extremely carefully take it off the loom. I'm doing it peg by individual peg. Okay, I'm gonna pause the video while I take off. Okay, so you have your Charizard head, but it's looking pretty flat. So first, you're going to want to stick your hook in that first double looped band and pull up with the horn. That way it's bent. Do it for the other one. And for the neck, stick your hook in all the way through just underneath the horns and pull upwards. And so the neck should stay bent like that. And here's your tricep head. Roar! It's so cute. Okay, so take three black bands and put it on the center of your loom. Another three black bands. Now we're switching to two bands, so two black bands. And two black bands again. Now switching to double loop bands, take a double loop black right here, double looped black here, and two more double looped right here and here. And now for the capping band, wrap it around your hook four times or your peg. So you have four rings, put it right here, and loop up, should know basic looming, and pull it off. And just fix up the capping band, see how it looks. Yeah, I know it's missing the fire, we'll add that afterwards. Just put it off the side. Okay, so now we are going to finally start on the body. Once you're to this point, you should have a head, two wings, two legs, a tail, and two feet. Just like to say that wherever I am placing down dark blue bands, you're going to be placing down black bands. And it's almost always two bands unless I say otherwise. Okay, let's get started. Only do this next step if you are having spikes on the body. Otherwise, just place the bands as normal. So we're gonna take one of our spikes and we're gonna put all six ends on our hook. And we're gonna take two black bands and we're gonna slide that black spike onto it. And just place the spike as if it were normal. A normal band. Okay, do this again. Put all six ends on your hook. Sorry, and now we're just going to place a normal band. And then we're going to take two bands and pull the spike onto it. And again, just place the spike as normal. Another two bands. Placed normally. Another spike, put it on our hook. Make sure you get all the ends. Two black bands. Slide your spike onto it. And now everybody's going to do this part. We're going to take all six ends of our tail now. And then we're going to take two black bands and slide our tail onto it. Like so. Make sure you have only two bands on your hook once you're done. If you have more than two bands, then that's the bands from the tail and you want to loop those over. And then just place it like normal. And we're gonna go down on the sides five times. So one, two, all with two black bands, three, four, and five. And on the other side, two black bands, one, two, three, four, and five. And then slide those bands down. We're going to be putting a bunch of more stuff on top of it. And then we're going to close it off from this side to the center and from this side to the center again. Now we're going to cap it off. Wrap one single black band around your hook or peg four times so you have four rings. Put it on the last peg. And now we're going to place our wings. So put your hook through the first set of bands. It should be black. Take off the slip knot. If it's too tight, you're going to have to cut it. And place it on the second to the top peg. And then put your hook through the blue row of bands. Should have a slip knot. I already cut mine off. And there's one wing on. And now for the second wing. Undo the slip knot. Okay, and put it on the second to the top peg. Like so. And same for the white row. Okay, and put it on the one after it. So now you have your wings on. Push down the pegs with the wings on it. And now we're going to put on our holding bands. Put one right here. Sorry, two black bands for your holding bands. Make them in a triangle like so. Here too, again, two black bands. Two black bands here. Two black bands here. Okay, so now for our final holding band, take two black bands and put it in a triangle like so. So now we're going to begin looping. So reach under this capping band and grab the top two black bands. And then loop them over to this peg. Again, top two black bands. Loop them over to the side. And the next two black bands, which should be the only one. So now we're going to continue reaching under, looping up, and we're going to do this all the way to here. Do not go any further, because then we're going to have to attach the head. Reach under all these holding bands and grab the bottom two black bands. Loop up, do not loop any further. Do the same thing on this one, grab the bottom two black bands. Now we're going to take one of the feet and put them on our hook. You're going to want to make sure that you have one, have all six ends on your hook. And that the hook is pointed towards you, you want to make sure that the claws are pointing away from you, like so. So again, we're going to grab up this loop band and put it on like so. And so now our toes are pointing upwards. We're gonna do the same thing for the second foot. So make sure you have all six ends on your hook. Again, grab up that loop band and slide the foot onto it. Like so. And now we're going to just pull back our feet and we're going to continue looping up. Grab the bottom two, loop up, bottom two, loop up, bottom two, black bands. Be careful you don't loop any of the wings. And loop up, don't loop any further. Again, we're going to loop to this peg. So reach under, grab the bottom two. Reach under, grab the bottom two black bands. And loop up. Okay, now we're going to put on our head. So reach in through the first slip knot and undo this slip knot that you just put it in. Make sure that there are four loops on that one end. Okay, now put the farthest end onto the farthest peg, like so. And now we're going to repeat with the middle. And take off the slip knot. You need to pull the two different pieces of that double looped band apart from each other. And then that will make it easier to pull off the slip knot. Like so. Again, make sure that there's four and put it on the middle peg. So the middle row goes to the middle peg and the farthest row goes to the farthest peg. And now for the last one. I only got three of the loops, so you want to make sure that you got four. Again, undo the slip knot and put it onto the farthest right peg. And even out the hip. And now we can continue looping with the center. Loop up. And with the last one, loop up. And same with this side. Make sure you got two. And now we're going to put on the hands. Okay, so take your holding hook and one of your arms, lift up the farthest right band or the farthest left band, do the same thing, and then just slide the arm on and replace it, like so. Again, with the other side, take the arm and slide it on. And replace that band. Just like we did with the feet, but with the arms. And so now we are going to carefully slip knot off our ends. Insert your hook through the farthest left peg. And just do a basic slip knot with black. Like so. And then also through the middle. Make sure that when you're doing the slip knot, you're not bringing your hook out through the side, you're bringing it through the middle. Otherwise, you're going to be looping this part of the head. Okay, and take one black band, make sure it's not about to break or anything. And put it through. And slip knot it off. Make sure you don't catch any of the other slip knots. As you can see, I'm not slip knotting this side part, I'm slip knotting it through the middle. And now for the farthest right, put your hook in. A bit easier of a slip knot this time. And again, just a basic slip knot, put both ends in your hook to the one that's closest to you and loop it over. Pull the slip knots tight. And now we are going to peg by peg, as to not break any of the bands, take our Charizard off the loom. And now I'm just gonna rip them off. Okay, and so here's our Charizard. We do have three loose bands, and we're just going to take those and we're gonna loop them over the head, like so. So they just wrapped around the head so that they're more hidden. Make sure you don't get the spikes, otherwise that's gonna look weird. Okay. Now we're just gonna be adding some finishing touches, like straightening out the wings, adding the belly and the fire. But first we need to make sure that the arms are curved upward, the spikes. You can see already with this one, the spikes are curved upward. We're just gonna stick our hook through the double loop band of the arm spikes that's closest to the arm, and we're gonna pull outwards and upwards. And do the same on the other side. Like so. So now we have the spikes pointing upwards. If you wanted to, you could just leave your Charizard how it is, but I'm going to insert a paperclip into the wings, I'm going to add a belly, and I'm going to add fire onto the tail and onto the mouth. First, we are going to be making the belly. So our bellies are going to be the same color. Take two light blue bands, putting it in the center. And go down two more times, so one and two. And then off to the sides, go down two times, so one, two, and on the other side, again, with two light blue bands, go down twice, push down all these parts. Wait one moment, sorry. Take these off. Sorry about that. Put it on the side and this one on the side. And now we're gonna be going down two times on both sides. I just did that so that we could loop it, otherwise it would fall apart. And now from closing it off, just like we did with the body and on. Okay. So now we're going to be taking one black band at a time. I'm putting one right here. Just stretch between these two bags. One right here. And one right here. We're going to add on another one, but that's going to be later. This might look weird, but it's going to be very important in attaching it to the Charizard. As you can see, those bands are attaching it. Like so. Now for the holding bands, take two blue bands, stretch it between. Make sure it's a triangle. Covers more bands that way. And our second one right here. Now, for capping it off, wrap it around our hook or our peg four times. Okay, so take your capping band, wrap it on your hook or your peg four times, and put it right there. And reach under the capping band, and grab the first two light blue bands. And then the next two light blue bands. And the last two light blue bands. Okay guys, sorry about how the camera is blue, but my camera will not white balance. Anyway, let's continue with the tutorial. So reach under and grab the bottom blue bands and loop up. Reach under, grab the bottom blue bands, loop up. Reach under, loop up. Make sure that these bands on the side do not fall off. If they do, your belly will not attach. Okay, and loop to the center. And loop to the center. And now we're going to take one black band and use that as a slip knot. Okay, so basic slip knot. Okay, and take it off the loom. Like so. Okay. And just to give credit to Courtney Nicole for the stomach attachment, a link to her channel will be in the description. You should go check it out. She makes awesomely huge dragons. Okay, so just set the belly where you want it on your dragon, your Charizard. And see how there's some looped bands right under these loose bands. You're going to want to stick your hook through the bands underneath and pull your loose bands through. Like so. You're going to want to do that for all of these. So there's one. It does not need to be the exact same bands as I'm using. Just needs to be under where these loose bands are. Make sure you don't get any of the light blue, only the black. Okay. And now for the top one. I used the same technique in attaching the stomach of my mini Charizard. So if you did mini Charizard, you should be used to this. Okay, so now you're going to want to grab the first band. Actually, no. Start with this side band. And open it up. And pull this bottom band, the bottom loose band, through. So it's catching that. And then do it again with the next band and do it again with the last band. And then just loop the last band over the head like you did before. Okay, so now he has this nice belly. It makes him much stiffer. You can see. And there's a couple more things that we're gonna do before we're done. And one of those is adding on the fire at the end of the tail. I would recommend using three light blue and six bands in total. So three light blue and three dark blue. And you're going to want to stick your hook through the capping band of the tail. Make sure you have all of the bands. And make slip knots of alternating light blue and dark blue through the tail. So there's one, and now I'm going to be doing dark blue. Like so, basic slip knot, and move it to the bottom so that we can fit in more. You're gonna want to do this until this tail is full or you feel like you've added enough fire at the end. Okay, I'm going to cut the video because it's pretty boring and repetitive. Okay, so now we're just going to cut these bands. You can do it at the middle, or you can do it at the bottom to give varying lengths of the fire. I did it with this guy. It did not make that big of a difference. effects that look kind of cool. Here's your fire. And now we're just going to do the same thing for the ones around the jaw. So stick your hook through these outermost looped bands by the jaw. Right there. And I recommend only doing two bands per side. So there's one band of light blue. Slip knotted it. And now for our band of dark blue. Like so. And again, cut it. Cutting it again so it's the same size. Okay. And then just do it on the other side. Okay, so now we have the fire on our tail and the fire on our jaw. And there's just one more problem, is that these wings are really flappy. And my other Charizard, I just unbended a paper clip and I stuck it through and then I bent it. So that's what I'm going to show you how to do right now. Okay, so stick your paper clip through that capping band. And push. Kind of have to navigate it. Sorry, you guys can't really see. I can't really see it either. Kind of have to navigate it through the wing. Can take some practice if you have not done this before, but it makes it look much better when you're done. And you also want to stick it through the body so that it goes through the wing as the other wing on the other side. Okay, and just keep on doing that until your wings are stiff or you run out of paperclip. Okay, so now our wings are really stiff and you just want to bend them to how you want them. Okay, so now we are done with our Mega Charizard X. I made this like ice colored Mega Charizard X because I did not have the colors for shiny Mega Charizard. I also have a Mega Charizard Y, which I do not yet have on my channel, but I will most likely have him soon. There are more pictures of him and a mini Charizard that I have on my channel as well. If you do end up making this guy, please post him to Facebook or Instagram. We'd love to see him. Goodbye!